Riverwood, oh, it's got a great history to it. Back in the early 1600s, it was still owned by a group, a McLean clan that came over from Scotland that owned a lot of acreage. It was called McLean's Bend. The Porters came in late 1700s, purchased that property and built Tammany Wood, which is what they named the mansion back then. It was their little town in Ireland that they had left is what they named it after. The original house was four rooms, 16 by 16, but it had the smokehouse attached, which is very unusual. It's only the second house known in Tennessee to have the smokehouse attached to the living quarters. So that's kind of interesting. In the 1820s, the Porters added an addition. It was a couple of feet off of the old house. They built a few more rooms in much larger, grander scale. And in the 1850s, they came in, and they say that William Strickland helped with the design of everything, with the Egyptian look and lotus leaf look and everything. And that's when the Grecian columns pillars went out front, and the rest of the rooms were completed in large scale. So in 1859, the Porters sold the mansion to the Cooper family, and it's been in the Cooper and Birch families up until the late 70s, maybe 79 or 80 is when other owners started coming in and hopes to repair it. And then finally Jackie and Joe Glenn came in 94 and purchased, and they've brought it to where it is today. The main part, the very first part of the house, since it was built in three stages, I talk about it as first, second, and third. The first part of the house has a limestone base and then just brick. And all the brick for every piece of this mansion was made off of materials that were found on the 2,500 acres. I would like to think probably closer to the house than further to keep it simpler. But every brick was made right here on the property, so that's kind of a neat little tidbit. The second part of the house is again on a limestone foundation with sand in between. But the interesting thing is the main beams downstairs are just cut trees, about 8 inches in diameter, 6 inches in diameter, still with bark on them. And that's what supports this house in between the limestone walls. So just the way that it was built and the magnitude of weight that it holds up is just amazing. The red glass, it's beautiful around the front door. Apparently, the red glass is said to be caused by lead that's actually in the glass itself. And the reason for it, during the daytime, people could look out to watch for Indian attacks or during the Civil War to see if soldiers were coming to attack. They could just peek out without being noticed because it's like a one-way window, sort of. At nighttime, with the lights on in the mansion, it shines bright red out into the front porch, and it was known as a sign of royalty. So it let people in the neighborhood know, you know, that this was a place with very well-to-do homeowners. Well, Jackie and Joe did a wonderful job bringing Riverwood back. It had lots of structural problems when they purchased, and they did a great job taking care of all of that. And lately, we're making some minor changes, doing like a fresh look. And we have come across some of the neatest little artifacts or pieces of history, from old locks and hinges to books that Dr. Birch used while he was attending Vanderbilt to write down the patient's progress and everything, all these handwritten books and an old prescription pad and medicine bottles, just neat things that, you know, a lot of people might overlook, but just the fact that we're able to bring some of the history back to the mansion is so important to me, and to be able to share that with, you know, Middle Tennessee means a lot. Riverwood, I think I mentioned earlier, was 2,500 acres. It went all the way to the river and then beyond just a little bit. And Riverwood actually had a view of the river at one time. You could actually see the river from the upper porch and windows of the mansion. It was a cattle farm. and an orchard. They had lots of fruit trees on the property. They had multiple cows and horses, and it was just a wonderful farm at one time. We are so fortunate to have 8 acres right smack dab in East Nashville. It's very unusual and very sought after. So we are really excited that Jackie and Joe had implemented a gorgeous English style garden, which we are bringing back to its glory. A lot of the trees on the property are a few hundred years old, so they just mean so much to us. We are also going to be planting in the back a garden so we can do farm to table foods and keep it fresh and local, and just looking forward to maintaining the grounds and building those back up and making use of the property here.